Now that is a very unusual hat. I wonder what's under a hat such as that. It could be the creature they call the Gazette, who bounces things on his head because it's flat. Or a stripe-loving hipster from an upper Mount Bat. Or maybe a sort of a hat-wearing cat.
I can see that you've got quite a mind for your age. Why, one think, and you dragged me right onto the stage. Now that I'm here, there's no telling what may ensue. With a cat such as me, and a thinker like you. Oh, the things you can think, oh, the things you can think, if you're willing to try. Think invisible ink, or a gink with a stink, or a stare to the sky. If you open your mind, oh, the things you will find, lining up to get loose. Oh, the things you can think, when you think about this. Think a beautiful schlock
with a cherry on top.
You don't need an excuse.
All the things you can think
when you think about Seuss.
Of an elephant tall as a tree.
Think
of a person too tiny to see.
Think
of a bird with a one feather tail.
Going on adventure down a dangerous trail.
Think
of a bird who flies off of a tree.
Think
Think of a general breaking for war.
Think of something horrible and scary, something sinister and scary that you never dared to think of before. Nobody here, and a feeling of fear, and the darkness of night. Ooh, all alone in your room, as you're facing your doom.
Think a glimmer of light. But I hope you're prepared to be scareder than scared,
cause this ain't Mother Goose.
Danger's right on the brink
when you think about Seuss.
Seuss, Seuss, Seuss,
Seuss,
Seuss, Seuss, Seuss, Seuss, Seuss.
An unusual story will soon be unfurled of an elephant trying to save a small world and a boy from that world who has thinks just like you.
Yes, think from the planet of Pooh.
And the smallest of smalls
to the jungle of Newell.
And the largest of all.
You think and 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 think. Just think. Oh, the things you can think. Think and wonder and dream far and wide as you dare. When your things are run dry, in the blink of an eye, there's another thing there. If you open your mind, oh, the things you will find, lining up to get loose.
Oh, the things you can think,
oh, the things you can think.
Oh, the things you can think,
oh, the things you can think.
Oh, the things you can think,
when you think about Seuss. When you think about Seuss. When you think about Seuss.
Our story begins with a very strange sound, the drums of a jungle beginning to pound. Now imagine a sky.
Imagine bright blue.
It's the jungle of Newell.
Near the river Walloo.
Now imagine an elephant lumbering through.
Horton!
Yes, Horton. Horton hears a who.
On the 15th of May.
in the jungle of Newell, in the heat of the day, in the cool of the pool, he was splashing, enjoying the jungle's great joys, when Horton the Elephant heard a small noise.
Help! Help!
So Horton stopped splashing, he looked toward the sound.
That's funny,
thought Horton.
There's no one around.
Then he heard it again, just a very strange yell,
as if some tiny person were calling for help.
Help!
I'll help you,
said Horton.
But who are you and where?
He looked and he looked, he could see nothing there.
But a small speck of dust blowing past through the air.
I say, how confusing. I've never heard tell of a small speck of dust that was able to yell. Do you know what I think? I think that there must be someone on top of that small speck of dust. Some poor little person who's shaking with fear that'll blow in the pool. He has no way to steer. He's alone in the universe. I have to save him because, after all, a person's a person no matter how small.
So gently and using the greatest of care, the elephant stretched his great trunk through the air, and he lifted the dust speck and carried it over and placed it down
safe
on a very soft clover.
Humph, humph the voice. T'was the sailor kangaroo, and the young kangaroo in her pouch said, humph, to oh, why, that speck is as small as the head of a pin. A person on that, why, they never has been.
It's true, please believe me. I tell you sincerely, my ears are quite keen and I heard it quite clearly. I know there's a person down there. And what's more, quite likely there's two, even three, even four.
Ha! That's your boys. Ha! That's the mothers. Ha! 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 That's the Wickersham brothers. Monkey's the biggest flame pool in the jungle of Newell, and monkeys like us should know.
He's slow.
Elephants ain't too swift as a rule. Oh, he's the biggest blame fool in the jungle of Newell. Cause he's talking to a speck of dust.
Blame fool in the jungle of Newell.
Talking to a speck of dust.
Blame fool in the jungle of Newell.
Elephants who hear voices. What do you think, folks? Is the elephant off his trunk? We'll be right back with dust, speck, clover, neighbor, who? Nothing. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Biggest blame fool in the jungle of Newell.
I'm Gertrude McFuzz, and I live right next door. He's never done anything crazy before.
Biggest blame fool in the jungle of Newell.
He's always been friendly and loyal and kind. I just don't believe Horton's out of his mind.
Did you hear?
I'm Mayzie the bird, and I live in that tree.
Did you hear?
Nothing about Horton. Let's talk about me.
Let's talk about me.
talking to a stag, talking to a stag, to a stag at dusk.
Play pool in the jungle on
talking to a stag, talking to a stag, to a stag at dusk.
Play pool in the jungle on
I just have to save them because after all, a person, no matter how small. A person, no matter how.
Biggest flame fool in the jungle of Noah, he's the worst we ever saw. Telling lies, making jokes,
it's an elephant hoax.
Brother, that's against the law. Breaking the peace, creating a fuss.
Somebody's thinking different than us.
Biggest flame fool.
Again, calling over and over.
Help!
So we tried to think what could possibly be down on that clover.
Hello? Is anyone there? Who are you?
Well, we're who's here. We are who's here. Smaller than the eye can see. It's true, sir, we're who's who, sir. I'm a who and so is she. We're tiny little people floating by in the air, wondering how and why. We're on who, the tiniest planet in the sky. A lot, a lot, a lot, a lot, a lot. Struggling to stay alive. Each dust propels our dust. So how the heck do who survive? At any given moment we could crash or be drowned, hitting the ground. Oh my! Here I go, the tiniest planet in the sky.
I'm the mayor. Just imagine the Who's unusual lives!
Tiny umbrellas that drip on the tiniest floors.
Tiniest tunnels and tiniest streets. Miniature buses with miniature seats.
Smaller town than yours.
We've got a marching band that is small but grand. Oh, you ought to hear them well. Every Christmas time, without fail, Mr. Grinch presents his Christmas tale.
I reenact my Christmas tale.
Every Who down in Whoville likes Christmas a lot, but the Grinch who lived just north of Whoville did not.
Imagine a place that is tiny and totally clean.
Ooh. Or even a Grinch wouldn't dare to be totally mean.
Ooh. You think that it's heaven on earth? Yes, you do. But heaven on earth isn't heaven on Who. Troubles on Who are the biggest that you've ever seen. We're on the brink of war, they say,
we're going to war in a lie.
Cause if we do, then here on who?
Well, you can guess who, they'll goodbye.
Our skies are unbearably dark,
and war is unbearably near.
And that's not the end of our trouble here.
For on the other side of town, the chocula trees were all cut down. They once stood tall in all their glory,
but that's another story.
So here on who we live in here, we're drifting through space and cannot steer. A troubled in our
future's in your hands.
It's up to you, sir. Please help the loser.
You're the only one who hears.
You must, sir, save our dust, sir.
Now that we have reached your ears,
we're tiny little people saying thanks in advance, hoping for chance you'll try.
Here on who?
The tiniest planet in the sky.
I won't let you down. No, I won't let you fall.
A person's a person, no matter how small. A person's a person, no matter how small.
An invisible world, amazing but true. We'll leave Horton to listen and zoom in on who. But guess who enters the story now?
Who?
You!
Meet a Who family on a small A.
Mom and Dad are just back from the Who PTA.
And here's their son, JoJo.
In trouble again.
Cause his things taken places where no one has been.
Now I'm the mayor of Who. I have just been elected. And upright behavior is thus forth expected.
But we've just had a talk with your teachers today, and they didn't have one single good thing to say.
You've invented new things which defy all description.
You gave Miss O'Dooley a nervous conniption.
Your things were so wild they disrupted your classes and made Miss McElhoo drop her new glasses. And that's why you're suspended. Yes, that's what they said. Young man, what in who has got in your head? Now, Horton has found us. We're safe on this clover. But clearly, our problems are far from over.
We don't mean to scold you. We love you. Oh, yes, dear. But couldn't you try thinking just a little bit less, dear?
Stop telling such outlandish tales.
Stop turning minnows into whales.
Now take your bath and go to bed. And think some normal things instead.
You got me in trouble. Get out. Go away.
All right. I'll be going. But first, let me say... Oh, the things you can think.
Stop.
Oh, the things you can
be
think.
Quiet.
As you splash and you splish.
I'm not listening.
As you sit there and scrub, have a think in the tub. Think of water and fish. Think of pipes on the floor, leading up to a shore where the water is cool. Soon your tub's not a tub.
It's Miguel, it's cool. This might be a pool like I've read of in books, connected to one of those underground brooks. An underground river that starts here and flows right under this bathtub, and then, who knows?
It's possible. Anything's possible.
It might go along down where no one can see, right under State Highway 203, right under the wagons, right under the toes. This is a Briso who's hanging out close. It's possible. Anything's possible. It's possible. Anything's possible. This might be a river. Now, might it be connecting the pool with the sea. Then maybe some fish might come swimming, swimming toward me.
Running right under the door.
The ceiling is peeling. You flooded the den. Oh, JoJo, I think you've been thinking again.
I say this with firmness and terrible sorrow. Young man, we will deal with you tomorrow.
It's possible.
Anything's possible.
We must both lay down the law.
Will he hate us?
Maybe so.
Oh, where are the instructions on how to raise a child? Who has the instructions on how to raise a child? Who has all the answers? I don't know. Troubles? Do his grades keep on shrinking?
Does he drive his teachers wild with his uncontrolled thinking?
As a parent, are you overwhelmed? Insecure? The help that you seek is inside this brochure.
It's night, sunrise, and shine, sun. It's a very special day.
Get dressed, dear. Look your best, dear. Soon you will be on your way.
Now here is your pencil.
Here is your mittens.
Here is your sword.
My sword?
I'm General Genghis Khan Schmitz, and I scare children out of their lights. But you'll see at a glance, my school is the answer. Circles and dreamers and twits. And in this case, I say the shoe fits. Ten hut, feet together, eyes on the prize, forward, march. The military academy is a place where he should be sent. We'll drill the silliness from his head, I'm sure we'll make a dent. We'll teach him fighting and left and righting until he's muscled and tan. A hut, two, three, he's pathetic, a hut. Two, three, and athletic, a hut. Two, three, but I'm betting we can. The military, that's what makes a boy a man.
Schmidt, 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 Schmidt.
why. Just a few short months ago, you would never have believed that this one refused to color within lines. This one sang in the shower. And this one actually had an opinion.
Our boys believe in the rights of every who to eat their bread.
Butter side up!
Butter side up!
The one thing we trust on this fragile speck of dust is eating bread. Butter side up!
Butter side up!
And as for those who like their butter down,
down, down, down,
we'll go to war and run them out of town. And boys soon see nothing's easier than the military. That's what makes the boy.
That's what makes the boy.
Amen. I do not like green eggs, Tim.
I do not like green eggs, Tim.
I do not like them, Sam. I am.
I do not like them, Sam. I am.
Sound off.
Eggs and ham.
Sound
Sam, I am.
I do not like green eggs.
Hey, ham!
I've been guarding this clover for over a week, getting laughed at for thinking dust that can speak. Well, let them all laugh. I'll try not to mind, for I found something that they'll never find. There are secrets on a leaf, in the water, in the air, hidden planets, tiny worlds, all invisible. Not a person seems to know, not a person seems to care. There's no one who believes a thing I say. Well, I'm fairly certain at one time or other, great thinkers all feel this way. I'm alone in the universe, so alone in the universe. I found magic, but they don't see it. They all call me a lunatic. Okay, call me a lunatic. If I stand on my own, so be it. 'Cause I have wings and I can fly around the moon and far beyond the sky. And someday soon, I know there you'll be. One small voice in the universe, one true friend in the universe, who believes in me.
I'm alone in the universe, my own planets and stars are glowing.
Alone in the universe,
no one notices anything. Not one person is listening. They don't have any way of knowing.
Nobody knows that I have wings, and I can fly.
I can fly
around the far beyond the sky. And someday soon you will hear my plea. One small voice in the universe,
one true friend in the universe,
please believe in me. Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Who's there?
It's me, JoJo, the mayor's son.
Oh, well, I'm Horton, the elephant.
Are you real or are you just a very large thing?
Oh, I'm real, all right. I would skate.
In my thinks, I go to lots of strange places, as if I had wings. I love a good think.
Well, for me, that goes double.
Sometimes, I think so might get me in trouble.
Oh. What do you think? Do you dream?
In bright colors.
Me too. And I go to strange places like Salt Blue.
When you think, do you think you could fly to the stars?
Oh. Oh, little friend. No one else can have things such as art. Yes, I have wings.
I have wings.
And I can fly.
I can fly.
Around the and far beyond the sky, you called my name and you set me free. One small voice in the universe,
one true friend in the universe,
who believes in me. Good night, JoJo.
Good night, Horton. See you in Salus Lou.
Wake up! The scene's over. There's much more to be heard. There goes our hero, who enters.
For Horton, 347.
One pathetic feather was all I grew. I had nothing show-offish. What's a plain bird to do? And there's certainly nothing show-offish on you.
Thank you, Mayzie.
Then I made a plan for my self-improvement. No more crumbs, I vowed I would have the cake. Yes, I went to the doctor.
Doctor, take by the lake.
And he told me what sort of a pill I should take. Now I'm amazing, Mayzie, as feathered can be now. Amazing, Mayzie, it was all for sale.
Amazing, Mayzie,
the birds are all whistling at me now.
Amazing, Mayzie,
baby, that's my tale.
Go.
Gee, I'm envious.
To and fro, Mayzie's fabulous tale.
I wish I had one like it.
Left and right.
Best I've ever seen.
Day or night.
Kid, you're turning green.
What a sight. Mayzie's fabulous tale.
doctor. The doctor named Dave, whose office was high in a tree by the lake. She cried, Mr. Doctor, oh, please don't you know of some kind of pill that'll make my tail grow?
Tut, tut, said the doctor. Such talk is too absurd. Your little tail is just right for your kind of bird.
Then Gertrude had tantrums. She raised such a din that finally the doctor just had to give in.
All right, already. Bring in the pill, Betty Bush.
What was that? Something's itching me. What was that? Something's twitching me. What was that? Are those feathers I see? I think my tail's beginning. Oh my word, this is wonderful. Second, third. Wow, I'm colorful. What a bird. I'm beginning to be amazing, Gertrude.
Just look at that tail, she is sporting.
Amazing. Thank you, Dr. Dick.
Thanks, Dr. Amazing Gertrude.
And hopefully I'll have resorted.
Amazing Gertrude.
One more pill will do me good. Yes, it will. One more pill.
Soon she'll have the biggest tail. She'll have the biggest tail.
I'll have the biggest tail.
The biggest tail of...
Her tail's nice and long.
Kid, fasten your seatbelt, cause now things go wrong.
Yeah.
There's a rustle in the bushes. Tremble in the trees. Hear it like a whisper. Smell it on the summer breeze. Something big is getting nearer. Something big is coming through. Got some funky business. That's what we intend to do.
Come on, we're gonna monkey, monkey around. Come on, we're gonna monkey around. Come on, we're gonna monkey. Ooh, we're gonna monkey around.
Ooh! The Wicker Shells!
Hello!
Well, it's bigger than a breath.
Hey, it's wider than a whale.
Oh, paint it for the breath. And scared to death from vegetation.
I suspect it's all for the wolves who are not.
I don't hear any hoof. Why? I don't hear a sound.
Come on, we're gonna monkey around.
Hey, come back! No, stop!
This is the Cat in the Hat live from Sky Cam 5. Folks, the jungle of New Orleans is one heck of a drive. We've got monkeys backed up to the 302. I'd find alternate routes if I were you.
Chasing the hoops, chasing the hoops, chasing the hoops.
agree.
Well, just to be sure, we are handing it off
to a black bottomed eagle named
Black Monica!
All that late afternoon and far into the night, that black bottom bird flapped his wings and passed flight. And he paid no attention to Horton's loud call.
A person's a person, no matter how small.
We're who's here, please don't let us fall. We're who's here, we could bruise your helpless against small.
On Horton traveled, and on that bird flew, and oh, there was trouble.
Trouble on who?
That black-bottomed eagle was cruel as could be.
6:56! Dropped it, the clover went crumbling, and no one stopped it, and head over heels, 100 miles down went the poor little hoos and their whole tiny town!
When the news is all bad, when you're sour and blue, when you start to get mad, you should do what I do. Tell yourself how lucky you are. When your life's going wrong, when the fates are unkind, when you're limping along and get kicked from behind, tell yourself how lucky you are. Why cloudy sky, an empty verse, a crazy universe. My philosophy is simply things could be worse. So be happy you're here, think of life as a thrill. And if worse comes to worse, as we all know it will, thank your lucky star, you've gotten this far. We're here in this beautiful theater, and you're in the front row. How lucky to be in the theater, more lucky than you know. You could have the luck of our hero, whose luck is running low. For certain, curtain! How lucky you are. How lucky you are.
Oh, that bird dropped my clover somewhere inside of a great patch of clovers 100 miles wide. I'll find it. I'll find it. I'll find it or bust. I must find my poor little friends. I just must. Clover by clover by clover with care. I'll listen and call. Are you there? 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 Are you there?
It's taken all my courage to approach you, not to mention all the stamina to follow you across the hills and deserts. But I feel as if I'm ready to confess to you the feelings that I've hidden with great diligence and labor. Behind the facade of your odd little next door neighbor. My eyes are too small, my very large feet, and I'm not very proud of my hidden feet. But I now got a tail that is something to see.
102? 103?
Oh, don't miss me, Horton, feather by feather. This is your next door neighbor calling. Don't miss me, Horton, Horton, together we could be great. Oh, don't miss me, Horton, put down my clover. This is your next door. There's a new leaf.
over and over, clover by clover. I was just a no one only yesterday. You showed up and showed me something more. Now I've become a someone who has someone to believe in and to be there for.
I will not give a poem. I'm straight from the start. My notice your kind and your powerful heart. So notice me, Horton.
Oh, the world would be something new.
Notice me, Horton.
If they noticed a thing or
two. Notice me, Horton.
The way I notice.
You said it, kid.
Who said that?
Oh, it's me, Mayzie, up here.
Oh, Mayzie, are you on a nest?
Yeah, you want to make something of it?
Oh, no. I just never thought I'd see you on a nest.
Neither did I, Hort. Neither did I. Just a girl on the wing. When I met sweet McFuzz, how could that night owl sing? Tell yourself how lucky you are.
How lucky you are.
We spent 3 weeks of bliss, then the usual seg. He flew off to San Juan, leaving me with this egg. Tell yourself how lucky you are.
How lucky you are.
Now I'm bored and I'm cranky and tired, sitting day after day. Who knew so much work was required? I'd much rather play. I need a vacation. I'm due for some rest. Hey, Hort, and would you make me like to sit on my nest?
Why, Mayzie, I couldn't. Of all silly things, I haven't got feathers, I haven't got wings. And not only that, but I'm here on a search. I just couldn't leave my poor who's in the lurch.
Oh, I won't be long, kid. I give you my word. I'll hurry right back because I'm that sort of bird. Oh, Horton, I promise I'll fly back real soon. I'll only be gone for, say, one afternoon?
Well, we all need vacations. All right, go on, take it. I'll sit on your egg and I'll try not to break it, but please, hurry back, an hour, maybe two. I need to find JoJo. I've got to save who.
Hit it, Cat! Thanks a million!
Then carefully, tenderly, gently, he crept up the trunk to the nest where the little egg slept. And Horton the Elephant smiled.
Now that's that.
And he sat, and he sat, and he sat, and he sat. He sat all that day, and he kept the egg warm. And he sat all that night through a terrible storm.
I'm cold and I'm wet and I'm catching the flu. Oh, Mayzie, please hurry. I've got to save who? Oh, Mayzie, please hurry. I've got to save who?
Hey, Horton, I brought you a scarf.
Thanks, Gertrude. Have you heard anything from Mayzie yet?
Oh, she said depart from Palm Beach.
Palm Beach! Gertrude, what if she never comes back?
Oh, don't worry. She will. Horton, you notice anything different?
Yes.
It's getting colder.
Oh, and then came the winter, the snow and the sleet, and icicles hung from his trunk and his feet. Oh,
I can't leave this nest. No, I meant what I said. Gusek might get frozen, but the Who's could be dead. I couldn't say no when I heard Mayzie beg. Now I'm caught between a dust speck and an incubating egg. Hunters! Hunters! Help! Help! Somebody help! No, wait! See that! Help! Someone help me! Help me! When your life's going wrong and you're wondering why.
When your tail is so long you're unable to fly.
Tell yourself how lucky you are.
When you land with a thud and you're bumped and you're bruised.
When you're trapped
and you're grounded and lost and confused. Tell yourself how lucky you are.
It's time for a brief intermission.
Which means our fun is through.
So go have a nice intermission. The lobby's a real zoo. But we gotta set up the stage and get ready to play act two.
So tell yourself.
You are. Seuss. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the moment you've all been waiting for. Without further ado, we present to you act...
Wait! What happens to Horton? Does Horton get free? Does Horton find JoJo?
There's no guarantee.
Will the egg be okay?
Here, I'll give you a clue. Once act one is done, then what happens?
Act two.
When we last saw our hero, he was hopelessly trapped.
Shoot if you must, but I won't run away. No matter what happens, I promised I'd stay.
The Who's had all crashed and their whole town was scrapped.
We're lost in the clover. We need to be found. Sir, why do we just keep on marching around?
And Gertrude was helpless. I think you know why. Her tail was so long, she could no longer fly. Our story resumes on a terrible day as Horton gets carried away.
Like a cork.
Egg nest and tree.
He landed at last in the town of New York.
Egg nest and tree.
He was wet, he was tired and hungry and cold.
Egg nest and tree.
Then Horton was taken to auction.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Seuss Bees. Our first item up to bid is lot 39, a pendulous pachyderm on egg, nest, and tree. Our bidding will begin at 10,000. Do I hear a 10,000 in the crowd? 10,000, 20, 20, okay, 30, yes, 40, yes, 50, yeah, 60. Yeah, yeah. 70. Here you go. What do you got? What do you got? How much are you gonna pay? What? All the money in the world? Nobody can beat that. Going once, going twice, and sold to the man in the greasy black and the sideburns. Oh, sorry, madame. Of the small and the tallest of the tall. Come old and young, come one and all. It's the Circus McGurkus, the world's greatest show on the face of the earth or wherever you go.
The Circus McGurkus is only one feet. The marvelous, tens of feet.
Ah!
Yippee! Woo!
modern bloke can it be who sits on an egg in a nest in a tree?
Trouncing along on a road full of ruts, getting jeered by a throng and performing for nuts. Tell yourself how lucky you are. There's a crick in my tail and a cramp in my toes. I'm on who knows what trail and where who is who knows. Tell yourself how lucky you are. I'm worried for JoJo and all of the rest. They're lost in the clover. I'm stuck on a nest. I'll sit on this egg, cause what else can I do? Oh, Mayzie, please hurry. Vacation is through. Oh, Mayzie, please hurry. I've got to save who?
In Palm Beach with the breeze in your hair, and you don't have an egg or a nest but hair. Tell yourself how lucky you are.
How lucky, how lucky you are.
When it's day after day after beautiful day to be lazing away by the sea with Jose. Tell yourself how lucky you are.
How lucky you are.
Still, I'm bored and I'm cranky and tired, sitting day after day. Who knew so much work was required for nothing but play? I need something different. I crave something new. Hey, maybe could you think of something different to do? A circus? I love a show. I think I'll go. Goodness gracious. I've seen you before. Now, let's see.
Why, Mayzie? It's Horton. Remember? It's me. I've sat on your egg now for 51 weeks. I've sat here while people have paid to take peeks. I've sat here through rainstorms and thunder and snow. Won't you take back your egg?
Gee, I really don't know. Oh, wow, it's really late. And gee, I've got a date. And lots of places to be, but it's so great to see you. Look at you. Who would ever guess? Look at you! Such a big success! And it's all thanks to me. Amazing Horton, that egg-sitting circus sensation. Amazing Horton, even I'm impressed. Amazing Horton, while I was off taking vacation, you made your fortune upon Mayzie's nest. I may be unreliable, fancy-free, irresponsible, crazy me, always eager
of seeing you gives me true delight. Just this once, I've done something right. The egg is all yours. No, don't thank me. I'll cry. Good luck when it hatches. Good luck and goodbye.
I meant what I said, and I said what I meant. An elephant's faithful, 100%. And now, little egg, you're alone in the universe, too. Who would have thought you'd be left up to me? A fool of an elephant up in a tree. Well, this time I swear I'll do better than try. I'll protect you from harm. Yes, I'll do it or die. So rest now, young egg, and I'll sing you a lullaby. There's a faraway land, so the stories all tell, somewhere beyond the horizon. If we can find it, then all will be well. Troubles there are few. Someday we'll go to Sala Salu. Sala Salu, Sala Salu. Sala Salu. I've lost my poor hooves, and I've traveled so far. Oh, JoJo, forgive me, wherever you are.
Dear Mom and Dad, I'm thinking of you and wishing all in Sala Salu. They say breezes are warm there,
and people are kind. Maybe it's something like heaven. I close my eyes and I see in my mind skies of bluest blue.
Sala Salu.
I've had so much trouble finding my way there. When I get close, it disappears. If we can get there, we're gonna stay there. If it takes us miles,
if it takes us months,
if it takes us years. High on a mountain or lost on the sea, sooner or later I'll find it. I have a picture of how it will be
on the day I do. Troubles will be through,
and I'll be home with you.
Sala Salu. Sala Salu. Sala Salu. Sala Salu. Sala Salu. Sala Salu. Sala Salu.
I'll be home with you.
Sala Salu.
Shit,
sound off,
eggs and ham,
sound off,
Sam I am,
I
do not like green eggs and ham.
We've arrived at the war like I said that we would, and war's a thing that every boy does good. We'll sleep in the trenches and go without supper to make the world safe for each butterside upper. We'll shoot all the traitors and all out-of-towners who side with those biblious butterside downers. Any questions?
This war makes no sense. Just one thing and you'd quit. Spreading bread up or down doesn't matter a bit. We've crashed in the clover, there's no hope in sight. So why are you here teaching children to fight? And not only that, sir, it's Christmas on who? I'd rather have Christmas than war, wouldn't you? So here's my sword and here's my hat. I'm going now and that, sir, is that.
It's a minefield out there. There's no time for play.
Think what I think, now get out of my way.
Soldier, you will obey. You will halt. JoJo, come back. Son, wait. Don't go.
Puzzling, how could it be so?
It came without tags!
He puzzled and puzzled till his puzzler was sore. Then the Grinch thought of something he hadn't before. Maybe Christmas, he thought, doesn't come from a store. Maybe Christmas, perhaps, means a little bit more. And what happened then?
Well, and who do they say that the Grinch's small heart grew three sizes that day?
And he brought back the toys and the food for the feast. And he himself,
he caught the Grinch part, the roast beast, part the beast.
Thank you, Mr. Grinch. As always, a wonderful Christmas show. And may I say, we're most grateful this year, since we've had much trouble, I fear. Our clover has crashed, things smashed, and things tore. Our town is a mess, and our plants at war. But it hasn't stopped Christmas from coming. It came, one way or another, it came just the same. So let's make a toast that the war won't arrive here, that Horton will find us, and we'll all stay alive here.
And here's to our JoJo, our sweet, precious son, who's still up at school, and I'm sure having fun.
In the Battle of Butter, your son has been lost.
Lost?
When the battle began, the young man paid the cost.
Oh no!
He did not want to fight, and he may have been right. His sword and his hat, regrets and good night.
Dreary, the parents despairing and terribly teary, their son JoJo no longer alive. But wait, could it be that the kid did survive? A reenactment.
It's a minefield out there. This is no time for play.
Sir, I think what I think. Now get out of my way.
JoJo, you will halt. You will obey. Son, wait!
I do. I'm lost and I'm frightened and don't have a clue. You said you'd be there if I needed you to. I'm thinking of you.
Is telling you you could be lost.
Lost.
I believe you down a path you have already crossed.
Cross.
Soon you're overwhelmed by hunches that pester and pinch and punch. And you know you're having a hunch.
Just trouble galore. You flooded my house, sent me marching to war, filled my head full of things, and you won't go away.
All right, fine, I'll go. But first, let me say...
No.
We've got nobody here, and the feeling up here, and the darkness of night. All alone in the gloom, as you're facing your doom, think a glimmer of light.
You mean, that's it?
That's it. You're a thinker, JoJo. Tried and true. I don't often meet thinkers like you.
I want to go home.
Why, that's easy to do. Just follow your hunches. They'll lead you to who? Think a bridge to the shore, or a road to your door. You'll be home before lunch.
Oh, the places I'll go if I follow my hunch.
Follow your hunch.
Follow it.
you forgot about Gertrude McFuzz. Well, that's nothing new. I mean, everyone does. But Gertrude did something that few birds could do. So this is the tale of Miss Gertrude, part two.
Psst. Horton! Horton! Are you there?
Who's there?
Oh, Horton! It's me, Gertrude! I was so worried! Are you all right?
Gertrude? How did you find me?
Well, it's a long story. I had a little trouble because I grew a little tail. Well, it wasn't really little. It was absolutely giant. And it really was attractive, but you never even noticed. So I felt a little silly even trying. Besides, wish the tail was too heavy for normal flying.
Go on.
Well, when the hunters caught you, I could see that I'd been foolish because I couldn't even help you. No, I couldn't even fly. And I got so very frightened because I knew I had to save you. No one else was going to go through all the labor. It was all up to me. All you had was your next door neighbor. So I ran to the doctor. Tail has been a mistake. Dr. Dake, I've been foolish and vain. Look it out. Get off. I won't do it again. Ouch, it hurt a lot. Ooh, a tender spot. Just the one feather tail. But suddenly, I sailed on a junk that was practically sunk for you. I trampled through the trees full of furious bees for you. I saw through a fog in a choking smog, down a soggy slope through a stinking fog. What's left was grabbed by a vicious dog. For you, I found the snow in 11 feet low. For you, even though I knew I was catching the zoo, for you, achoo! And then came the hole where I caught my soul. I rolled down the hill out of all control. I broke my ball on a jagged shoal. And I couldn't, and I haven't gone down. I sprained my little toe, but I have a life for you. Yes, it's him, where I staggered on one for you. Now here I am, the worst poor wear, and here you are. I'm here. And Horton, one more thing. It took me 7 weeks, but I found your clover too.
Gertrude, I never noticed. You're amazing.
Oh. It was nothing.
Hello! Who's? Hello! Are you there? Are you all right?
Hello!
Oh, hello, Mr. Mayor, Mrs. Mayor. Is JoJo there?
Hi, Horton.
Oh, thank goodness. Kid, now that I've got you, I won't let you go. I'll shelter and guard you, because after all, a person's a person, no matter how small.
A person's a person, no matter how.
Ha! Ha!
Ow! What are you doing here?
Well, Horton, we're taking you back. You're gonna be going in style. For talking to a spec and sitting on an egg, you're gonna be
put on trial.
Woohoo!
The case of the people versus Horton the Elephant.
Horton the Elephant!
Judge Turtle the Turtle presiding, everyone cry.
Order, order, order in the court.
Order in the court.
The defendant is charged with talking to a spec, disturbing the peace, and loitering on an egg.
Your Honor, this clover is Exhibit A. There, who's here? They are. Who's here? Smaller than the eye can see.
Biggest playing fool in the jungle of noise.
It's true, sir. Here's who's who, sir. He's a who and so is she.
Biggest playing fool in the jungle of noise.
Order in the court.
Call to the stand the star witness versus Horton the Elephant. Raise your right hand and swear.
I said what I meant. An elephant's faithful 100%. You can throw me in jail, lock me up in a zoo, but I won't desert my egg and I will not abandon who. These who's, sir, win or lose, sir, whether you believe or not. They're here, they live in fear, and I'm the only friend they've got. You can do what you want with me, Your Honor, and I won't question why. But please save who? The tiniest planet in the sky.
Based on the evidence, I have no choice but to order the defendant, Horton the Elephant, remanded to the Newell Asylum for the criminally insane. And as for that dust speck.
Ooh, that dust speck.
As for the dust speck.
Ooh, that dust speck.
And as for your dust speck,
that we're gonna boil in a hot steaming kettle of diesel nut oil.
Oil it? No, that you can't move. There's persons down there. I'll prove it to you. Mr. Mayor, please, Mr. Mayor. You have to ring down that you really are there. So ring every doorbell. Send up a word. Make every who holler. Make every who word.
Boil.
Attention all who's. Attention all who's. We've got to be heard. There's no time to lose.
So send up a shout.
Make it loud. Make it clear.
We are here.
Now surely you heard. It was clear as a bell. Now surely you all heard it as well.
I heard no small voices. And you didn't either. Boil it.
Don't give up now. I believe in you all. A person's a person, no matter how small. And you very small persons will not have to die if you make yourselves heard. So please try.
We are boiling.
Now just for a moment, young JoJo looked grim. The fate of the Who's rested squarely on him. But then came a think, a peculiar new word, the sort of a word no one ever had heard.
Do you hear what I hear? Do you see what I mean? They made themselves heard. No, they still can't be seen.
They proved they are persons, no matter how small.
And their whole world was saved by the smallest of all.
Troubles were over. They hailed his grace.
Yeah!
And JoJo was honored as Tinker Nonstop.
Now all of his thinks would forever be heard.
Bird.
Like me. Except for the wings.
And except for the voice, because that's how a bird sings.
Gertrude, what do I do? I am slow. I am fat. I owe me no earth. He needs much more than that.
I have wings. Yes, I can fly. You teach him earth. And I will teach him sky.
Just call my name, and I'll see you through. One small voice in the universe.
One true friend in the universe.
Who believes in you.
What happened?
Well, what do you think?
All the things you can think. Think and wonder and dream far and wide as you dare. When your things have run dry, in a blink of an eye, there's another thing there. If you open your mind, all the things you will find, lighting up today.
I do not like them, Sam. I do not like them, Leroy. There, I do not.